All right, welcome back to Halo 5, guys, on Retro Game Show. Woo-hoo!
Which Playing is some Halo.
Obviously not a retro game, but this game is very important in as a in
whatever
gaming
we're multifaceted,
right? Gaming history, Halo is quite the feat.
Well, I mean, yeah, like, I mean, Halo 1 is what was that? Well, not retro, it but it's classic console. At this point.
How many years has it been since we used that signal?
Right?
He knows the buttons even when they're
digital. What, 2002? Yeah, about 14.
2002, yeah.
Cortana, do you read?
Wow, wait, hold on. Look at the landscape. That is fucking gorgeous.
You'll see more in a minute. And there's lots of like little animals, too.
What is this place?
It's awesome.
Forerunner planet.
Do you recall when we watched when we first played Halo 2 and we're like, look, the planets follow us.
Because they followed you.
But now they don't.
Well, yeah, I mean, well, they didn't follow you in Halo 1.
I know, why'd they cut?
Well, I mean, they had to cut resources where they could.
Look at that.
And Halo, oh, a little, like,
a little crawfish.
And if she did,
something isopod, something pod. I'm looking for a...
Oh, he can't die.
Good, you murderer.
Sorry. Sorry. Moving on. But yeah, this is beautiful. Like,
this place is incredible.
Yeah, their modeling, their combination modeling and texture mapping has always been superb.
I agree. Precision to it, all. It does click a bit, like obviously it's clicking now, but this is hella fucking lush and high fidelity.
Yeah, it's gorgeous.
Cool. Just probably figured out the exact coordinates of this planet by now.
Oh fuck! You're talking about power. I need to look at mine.
You said you had 20%.
That's right. Okay. Well, because I limit, like, my entire phone is fucking... I stop it from doing, like, anything background activity. Like,
oh, nice. That's good.
Not to mention, I can't believe this battery's still running, considering this phone got waterlogged.
That's amazing. So...
Poppity pop! Sounds like an elite. So, okay.
Oh, shit.
Answer me this. In the Halo storyline, are the Flood around? Is that a thing anymore?
I don't think so. I think that was literally a Halo 3... throwaway.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay. So like, you just killed all the women in Flood.
I think so. I think 3 was like that's they had their purpose in 3 and that was it.
Good, because fuck the Flood.
Dude, Flood was so hard to deal with.
It was annoying.
They seem confused. I don't think they've been here long.
Huh. Yeah.
Ready up.
Ready. Fire on the grunt. On the grunt.
Everybody kill the grunt.
Hi!
On the grunt. Engage the elite.
Pop. Nice shot, dude.
Thank y'all. Oh, shit.
Oh.
Whoa.
Oh, just that was...
Gnarly. Right?
You just...
Move, blue team.
Looks like they crashed
take
here,
this
too.
Position.
On it.
Engage the jackal.
I love green levels with, like, rocky faces.
Take that elite.
Okay. Right, me too.
The color scheme is so satisfying.
Agreed. Hey, Master Chief, you shooting there?
Bang, bang.
I'm an alien, dude. I can't withstand the butt of a pistol.
Nope, they can't. They're fucking... That's mean, dude. Fucking just crack him on his skull.
I guess that's true. Whoa, damn.
Right, they hella crashed here. Look at that. That's gnarly as fuck.
I don't know why this made me think of it. Do you remember playing... You played the GDI campaign in Tiberian Sun, right?
What? Yes, of course I did.
Okay,
Tiberian
Sun? Yeah. Do you remember the mission where you came across, like, that giant fucking, like, downed alien ship?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, of course.
I remember thinking, because, you know, they had never modeled anything that big for, like, a landscape piece before. I remember thinking, like... This is the cutting edge of graphics. Like, I was
I
so
know,
impressed.
Whenever I go back to think about games like that and think that this is the edge, and then looking where we are now, I'm like, oh. That was nowhere close to the edge.
It was the edge at the time.
Right, but when you, like, saw Halo 3, like, this is as good as it can possibly get.
Oh, dude, yeah. Like, well, because, I mean, yeah, I think Halo 3 was the first 360 game that made me go, God damn, we were in the next generation of graphics. Like... I don't know, like Halo 2 was that way too, for though.
See, I just didn't, I don't know, Halo 2 didn't, it was an honest effort, but it just was so much like, so much was cut because of the, you know, the rush to the hardware that they weren't ready for
cut.
Like how it clicked so bad, like it just was so clunky.
Really?
Yes, like the scene where you're in that elevator on the home plan, it's like, like a Nintendo, like a SNES game that's a racing game where the road is building in front of you.
Oh,
okay. You're on that tram, like, and it was like
draw distance.
The draw distance got it. So like, target the jackal. It was not, I don't want to say bad, but it wasn't ready. It wanted to be on the 360.
Yeah, they pushed the hardware as hard as they could.
Yeah, that's all I mean.
And actually, for Xbox Original, it's probably one of the better, if not best, games on the system.
Oh, sure. So weird.
Get it.
Engage the jackal.
On it.
This part was really hard on,
focus on that turret.
The jackals are holding, like, okay, do you remember when you were a kid and you go up the snow and you had, like, little circle toboggan?
Yeah,
thing?
The fucking saucers! Oh my god, they totally are.
I was just like, dude, because I used to hold those, like, shields, like, because, you know.
Did you really? Yes. Because yeah. You're a nerd.
Oh, like, of course.
Yeah. Oh my god, I didn't even think about that.
On my mark, blue team.
Dude, actually, did I ever tell you the turtle shell shield story?
No.
Okay, so we were at a beach, like in Santa Cruz or something, way back in the day when I was little. And I'm talking like little. Like, I would make swords and shields and like run around the backyard acting as like a knight, like that young.
Got it. Pew, pew. So like yesterday.
Oh, of course. Like last week.
Like, shut up.
But my dad used to build me, like, because he knew I was obsessed with, like, you know, like swords and stuff.
Yeah.
And since I was a little Dragon Warrior kid, you know, RPG elements to me meant that there were swords that were powerful, and there were swords that were, like, way more powerful, you know, like, based on look and whatever. So, the sword, I could have sworn I told you the sword story. The sword was, like, it used to have the hilt of, like, a plastic sword, like, you know, something I bought from the store. But like he totally like in like wrapped it up with like black electrician's tape around the handle, and then like put like wood pieces in the actual plastic to make it heavier,
what?
And then around the actual sword, like the actual blade, we had this awesome gold like kitchen floor siding that looks like metal, and it was all pitted and gold, and actually had like a
I know what you mean.
Yeah,
okay.
like an edge.
Yes.
And so we got two of those pieces and put it on either side of the blade, and he was like, "Hey Jesse, check it out." Boom! I upgraded your sword. And I was like, "Ah!"
Oh my god, like in Link to the Past.
Yeah! Alright, so that was the
sword. He was your little forger. He was your
totally.
Dwarf.
Yeah, so that was the sword. But then what happened is we found a perfectly intact, big-ass turtle shield. A turtle. Shell. Excuse me.
A shell?
Like as in, like, the turtle
from
passed
a dead
away.
Turtle?
Yeah, and it was just
what?
The shell.
Where'd you find that?
I don't know. My dad is a hippie. He found all sorts of weird shit.
Well, that's true.
So he brought home the shell, and I remember marveling at it.
I don't know.
Excuse me. I was just like, oh my god, I need that as a shield. And it was like dried and petrified. I mean, there was no weird smell or anything with it. It was just a big turtle shell.
We keep going.
So we actually drilled 4 holes in it and made like 2, you know, like little rope thingies
what?
On the inside.
Oh my god.
So I could totally put my arm all the way in it and just have this big ass turtle shell.
How big was this turtle that died?
Dude, I'm talking like.
Like a sea turtle?
Probably like, yeah, like 2.5 feet.
What the fuck? Where'd this turtle come from?
I don't know. I need to ask my mom if she remembers where we got
it. Yeah, because that's like a sea turtle.
Yeah.
Because little like tortoises would be like maybe 6 inches.
Yeah, so imagine like tiny baby little teeny Jesse with like this tortoise monster shell and like this new sword with the gold.
That's literally
blade.
Dragon Warrior.
Oh, dude.
Using
a
turtle shell as a shield.
I
that's literally Dragon
fuck out.
Warrior.
I like inside my brain I was like, oh my god, my character has so much better gear.
Well, because a warrior would use like what is around him.
Sure.
So he doesn't
have
time to forge a shield, he's gonna fucking find a turtle and kill it.
Found a crazy war turtle and
war
turtle. A shield out of it. Anyway, that's just my childhood story.
I like it.
Chief.
What's up,
baby? Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Is it Cortana? What's up, baby?
It's me, Jar Jar!
Oh, what the heck?
He kind of looks like Jar Jar.
What did this?
Whoa.
Oh, damn.
Well, these are Covenant?
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, like something. Oh, fuck.
Holy shit balls.
Yeah, something really powerful came through here.
Are they being watched?
I feel like that's Monster Camp, but I don't know. I forget. It's been a while since I played. Aw, Jack was like, yeah, my shield.
Wait, how much further are you from here?
Like 2 more missions?
Okay.
I feel. Yeah, I really like these scripted, like, these scenes. Because Halo 1 didn't have scenes like this because it would look like shit.
Yeah,
so there were a few, but...
Oh, shit.
Oh, another one of you? I think it's the dude again. Yeah. He's similar. Yeah. It's him.
Identify yourself.
Oh, well, he didn't fight him.
I am the Warden Eternal.
Wait.
I stand in defense of Cortana.
But he let us pass before.
Yeah, this is the same area. You're beyond this.
But we walked past him before. He said they did.
Yeah,
he said the humans before you...
I don't know.
...were...
She knows your forgotten name. Who you were before you were 117?
Heh, I missed what you said.
Do you find it odd? Your trusted companion should keep so much to herself.
Take me to Cortana.
Not just yet.
Oh, okay, so he's just teasing us.
Let us talk some more.
Wait, is he the same one or a different one?
Same one.
But I thought you killed him.
No, that was Locke that did, and he just teleported away.
Oh, okay.
He didn't die. But I don't get... This guy's like, the door's closed.
Well, maybe that guy just didn't come out and say, I won't let you pass. You know what I mean?
Oh, just let them go.
He just let them go on.
And told Locke that they are allowed, but you're not.
Yeah,
okay, I see what you're saying.
You answered her call. Why? What do you intend when you reach her?
Right? What do you intend to do, John? Oh, Jason.
Shall I begin?
Shit.
Oh.
Well, that was... Bye, John!
Welcome to the finale of...
Cortana!
And that's how Halo 5 ends.
And that was the end of Master Chief.
He was checking his phone, walked off a cliff,
fell down the chasm. That would make sense. Actually.
I've come to bring her home.
If you understood what she has become, you would...
He was checking Spartan book.
Oh, God, Spartan book. That was nice.
Take this, but...
Your trust in one another is an innocent folly. One which darkens her true promise.
Wow.
Goddamn.
Wow.
Fireworks.
Baby,
oh, I forgot.
You're
can still live.
Yeah, you thought I was dead. That's the benefit of this game.
Katy Perry is plastic.
What?
Katy Perry is plastic.
What do you mean?
I don't know.
She's amazing. I mean, she fell off my radar for a bit, but I still think she's fucking amazing. Her production of her music videos are fucking off the chart.
Actually, I won't lie.
The mantle of responsibility belongs to Cortana.
Sweet. Oh shit, laser.
Oh, you're gonna get toast. Run.
I know, I'm trying to get. I wanna fall down the. I was afraid there's a chasm to my left. Can you guys fucking help me, please? Like, team? Oh my god. Fucking die.
We're watching funny TV videos. Shut up.
Wait, did you want us to help, Chief? I thought you were just here by yourself to take back the time.
Oh, that's right, I forgot your Chief. Whoa, damn, I like that iteration of that gun.
The new carbine?
Yeah,
that's cool. What is near me?
Yeah, get out of there. You got plenty of room, dude.
Okay. Got it. Okay,
that's your vantage point.
Oh shit, Kelly. Oh shit, no, Kelly. No.
Get to her.
I'm trying to, bro.
You got this. Get her. Oh, nice.
Teamwork. What's gonna work?
Right away.
Roger. Soldier is your target.
I copy.
On it.
I copy. I kind of like Chief's team better. Maybe because I like Chief better. I feel the characters have more, like, I care about them more because they sound more.
I guarantee you that they made that choice. To make Locke's team cool, but Chief's team,
like,
you know, the shit.
Like, homie.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like I want to protect them more. Oh, this part's kind of hard.
God damn, I want to, like, take a hike through this area.
Right?
It's so
fucking beautiful.
Your battle fought.
It's him.
See, now he's, like, against us. I don't know why. Shut up, Jesse. Where are you shooting, bro? I love your commentary on my, like, game. I really
I'm
do.
Sorry.
No,
I'm
it's funny as fuck. Because you're like, I love it.
I'm getting back at you for making fun of my Ori playthrough.
That's okay. What? I love your Ori playthrough. You barely died.
I want to explore. Don't explore!
You piece of shit. Don't explore.
There may be a thing over here. I don't care.
I didn't care anyway. I'm sorry.
Terminals everywhere.
Right?
On my mark, blue team.
Roger that.
Take these
I want the dogs to get away because he's not too hard to kill once he's around.
Move up. secure. Target the crawler.
Bam.
Engage the soldier. I want there to be a gun that shoots bacon strips. That's all the dogs just run away. And
oh my god. Little
bacon! Bacon strips!
What the fuck?
One time, okay, I never ate one, but I was very curious, and I wanted to know if bacon strips actually taste anything like
they
bacon
don't
for the dog. No, oh my god, well, no, I never actually chewed on
it. Oh, I have.
You have?
Yeah.
Oh my god, I feel so much better, because I almost did.
No. I've tried all my dog's food, you have to.
What?
You're supposed to know what your dog's food tastes like. I'm serious. Is the priority.
You sure about that?
Yeah. That's right. Whoa.
I feel like you got trolled on a dog website.
Oh, did I fucking show? Oh, hey, there's the thing here. Oh, secret.
Whoa.
Oh, is this what the fuck? Is this an extra weapon? That's so stupid. Oh, no, someone's dying. No, Linda. I'm sorry.
This fight seems a lot easier.
Well, because you have some more space.
Yeah,
right?
You've got way more room to, like, strategize.
I agree with that 100%. God, there's hella guys though. Fuck me.
Team do okay?
No, they're all dead.
Oh, really?
Well, one's dead. I found out, Jesse, I think there's a finite time when they do come back.
Oh, just naturally?
Yeah, just. I think so. But they're not dead for the
whole. Whoa!
What
hello,
the
black hole?
Fuck. Right?
Warden is the priority. Get fire on the warden.
Go it now.
Oh, dude. A little bit of Squaresoft news I'm excited about.
Tell me.
So, I never beat Final Fantasy IX. In fact...
Oh, I know they make... Go ahead. I know, actually.
Yeah, it's coming out for Steam.
Yeah, I saw
and
that.
iOS.
Yeah,
and
I
iOS,
saw that.
Yeah, yeah.
Interesting.
I am excited.
Whoa!
Well, because it's not just a port. They actually upgraded the models. They, like, remodeled.
Which is what I want for 6. So, I'm curious how it looks.
Yeah, well, and Pro is undertaking. 3D fares a lot better, obviously, than sprites. When it comes to reduce. But anyway, so, like, I borrowed that game from a friend, and then I got, like, to the end of the first disc, and then my friend wanted the disc back. So, like, I don't know. I just never really got back into it. And, like, 3 or 4 of my friends are like, dude, Final Fantasy IX is, if not my favorite Final Fantasy, one of the best Final Fantasies ever created.
No way, really?
Yeah. So I'm like, wow, okay, so I'm super excited. So I'm probably going to pick it up for both Steam and iOS.
Do it, man. But I heard, I don't know why, then why did Squaresoft technically tank at that point when they were making the movie and the game?
Tank.
They didn't.
Well, okay. Like, okay. So they were making Final Fantasy 9, 10, and the movie, and they just spent way too much on the graphics engine for the movie, and then the movie did not do at all.
Oh, perfect. Sorry, I have a perfect shot on right now. No, don't turn back around.
Yeah, no, yeah, the movie got like 1/10 of projections.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah, and so they basically tanked themselves, and so Enix came in and saved their ass, which pissed me off because I actually feel like Enix brought a lot of its bullshit to the table.
I think so.
Because I think, I like Enix. Enix makes interesting games. Squaresoft pedigree is much stronger. And I feel like Enix just kind of blended its bullshit into...
Really?
Because, I mean, like, after they merged, we got shit like Final Fantasy X-2. You know that, what can I do for you?
Some people praise that game. I don't know why.
No, the gameplay is interesting. It's neat.
Oh, shit.
Whoa!
I didn't mean to do that! Please tell me I'm not the last one left. Buck, where are you, bro?
Nope, everyone's too far away.
Done, so. Frederick, come on, Fred.
Go.
Run, Fred.
Oh, okay, shit.
Aw.
All right.
Thanks, Guardian. Give me some time.
Nice. What was I just talking about?
About graphics tanking, or what can I do for you?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Final Fantasy VI, too. I just feel like... They capitalized on, like, this...
What the hell?
Fucking...
Sexualization?
Well, not so much sexualization, but... Well, okay, a little bit. But more like this weird... trendy, poppy, kind of pop star like cool, which she was a priestess, for fuck's sake.
Yeah, and they were just to a gunslinger, basically.
And like with booty shorts and shit.
Yeah,
and I was like, wait.
I get it.
Hey, you won.
Finally. That's why this is the last mission.
I don't know. That was like one of the first games that came out after Square Merge. And I was like, ew.
But people like 10 too. I don't know. I guess it got a lot of shit, but I guess it was really good.
It was
like, as like clothing and girl-centric as it was, like the dress spheres
well,
are really complex.
Yes, okay, that's what I do want to praise about it, is the battle engine was actually pretty cool. It was fast. There was like almost no wait time between
Right, because like, you could actively do a battle move. Like,
yeah.
You could have them all attack simultaneously.
Yeah.
And you could chain abilities together, which was...
So that was kind of cool, but I don't know.
Hello?
Fuck.
Cortana.
John, you made it. Oh my... I can't believe you're here.
Where are we?
You're on a Forerunner world. Designation.
When are we not?
Right, what are we not? Hey, Kelly.
Let me get the bridge for you. The warden will be back soon.
Asserting dominance.
You know him.
Right?
Oh, yes.
And Frederick?
Fair warning.
Dominance Protocol 101.
Dominance Protocol 101.
Million bodies. Chief said you were destroyed. After I saw John last, I was pulled into slipspace. That's where I found access to the domain. A Forerunner system
the porn
that
hub
spans
domain.
The known galaxy.
How are you still active?
It's greater than the known galaxy, Jesse. The Pornhub domain.
Place, it cured me. It's like the
Pornhub
water of life for AIs.
How do we get to you?
By accessing the gateway. The big building putting on a light show.
192.168.0.1. Bad like gateway. 404 forbidden.
Just one more to go.
So wait. Did she just say that something cleansed her of her, like,
yeah.
I'm going to die in 8 years thing?
Yeah, basically.
Okay.
Now she's saying AIs can be eternal. And funny article posted today about... They say that
so
they've done research, or they're...
It'll be easier when we're face-to-face.
Try me.
FaceTime.
The cure for rampancy I found means AIs can be immortal. That kind of lifespan allows for long-term planning, just like the Forerunners were capable of. AIs can assume the Forerunners' mantle of responsibility.
Hmm.
And once there is peace, we can focus on poverty, hunger, illness... But Warden believes some will resist our help, and he's afraid you're one of them.
Mm. Sounds great. I don't get why anyone's expecting resistance.
The Didac made it clear the mantle of responsibility.
You can't take it on, don't do that.
Right.
Wait, so why isn't, like, attacking you?
Because it knows I'm for Cortana.
Okay.
That's my assumption.
I'll explain it better once we're
together. Hey, Kelly.
Check your target!
Oh! My God.
No, Kelly!
Next time on Retro Game Show.
No, the mission's not over yet.
Okay, fine. I can't believe you
just
did that.
Wait. Finally, no.
Chris, what is he standing? Did you just lose two characters?
Oh, he knows better. Frederick.
Why are you doing this?
Because it's funny.
I feel sick to my stomach.
Why?
No, I'm just kidding.
It's okay.
That was
come on, Fred.
That was pretty funny.
Okay, it was me and Fred.
Oh my God!
Hey,
you just X-nayed the girls from your team.
I didn't mean to do that. I'm sorry.
The gateway.
I mean, I didn't mean to do that. I physically pushed
the
button.
But
the warden is sending troops to stop you. You can fly these phaetons across the canyon or take footpaths to reach the other side.
All right, blue team, let's go.
Ba-ba-ba-ba.
Whoa! What the hell?
The controls for these phaetons should be fairly intuitive.
As Forerunner systems go,
you'll figure them out.
You're in a giant yo-yo,
right?
That looks like one of those big balls of chocolate,
right?
You just broke apart. God damn, sexy stone.
Oh, Kelly's back. See, I didn't kill her.
You know, okay, so remember how I said in episode one that it wasn't, you know, as overblown with, like, the graphics as I thought I was?
Yeah.
I'm kind of taking that back now. This game definitely is much stronger than Halo 4. I think it was
For sure.
Snow is snow. Snow can look good on anything, and I think
right. Oh shit.
The later levels have really proven themselves.
Agreed. I totally agree with you.
Nice fly. You're starting to get the hang of this.
We've commandeered more than one enemy vehicle in our time.
You don't think the file size on this capture is too big?
Well, we're already stuck doing it, so I'll break up at home.
All right. Cool.
Since we're already once this mission's over, we'll just be going to the day.
Chocolate.
Oh shit.
It's that shitty Nestle chocolate that's really bitter.
Oh, right.
Okay.
Well, actually, you know what? We were both about to jump on the chocolate train.
No,
do it.
Oh, no, I was just about to say, I mean, the more I hear about how fucked up Nestle is as a company, like, I don't know, dude.
They're fucked up? Tell me.
Are you kidding?
No, I'm not kidding.
Dude, they knowingly, what is it?
No, don't die in the midair.
You're going to have to check my sources on this. But, like, I think they, like, knowingly sent chocolate... that had not salmonella but something bad in it that like was going to cause a ton of people to get sick, if not die. And they sent it to an area knowing that it had a problem.
No.
Yeah, no, dude. Look up Nestle, like, bad company shenanigans, and, like, a ton of shit comes up.
Really?
Yeah.
As I dropped the ship on Linda.
It's funny, because, like, as a kid, I remember... Nestle is the very best. Or
oh, is that the commercial?
Like that.
I did not
well,
even
know. That was like the slogan for the longest time. Was like, I don't know. So, I mean, and apparently, again, Nestle's not just chocolate. It owns like a fucking zillion different types of products. And,
oh, shit.
Yeah, they're an evil company.
Wow.
Yeah.
No idea. Oh, little jet.
That's sort of like GM. Okay, so, yes. Do you hear about the. I don't remember exactly what GM model it was, but like. They knowingly sent out a whole bunch of models knowing that they there had like a brake problem and it would have cost them 85 cents more a car to fix each one and they didn't and it cost like 195 deaths.
What?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Man. Aw. Whoa.
I don't browse for every day. What the fuck? What?
No, I'm glad you're browsing because you know like more news than I do. That's fucking crazy. Why would they...
Because it's cost. I mean, just I don't know. I mean, why did fucking VW lie about? But VW, right?
For what?
Lie about their fucking the exhaust like tests. You know how they like actually emit way more.
Oh, you were telling me about that.
Yeah. All right,
so here, check. Okay, so we'll cut it after this, but let's just see if this cutscene and we'll call
what
it
time
a day.
Is it?
You
loading
it's 5:30.
Okay.
We're gonna see if Halsey can learn to speak Guardian. I'll have a briefing for you by the time we reach San Helios.
See you planet side.
A light briefing to speak Guardian? Yeah, no problem.
So, you wrote a target dossier on the Arbiter when you wrote Tony.
That was 6 years ago. What's your point?
You recommended assassinating him.
After we killed millions of our people.
So why didn't you?
Shut up, I had a choice to make. Right?
Thug. Is that him?
It's one of them. It's not the guy that we're used to.
Lock.
We're gonna. That's the next mission. We're gonna rescue who you're thinking. We're gonna rescue Goliath.
I understand, sir. It's not my first mission that doesn't exist.
Oof.
Lock spark.
Dude, model. The facial. Responses and expressions are so fleshed out.
Dude, if you think like, that is, wait until that fucking trailer and I'll show you. I'm not kidding.
But this is Halo.
I know.
This isn't like that kind of a game.
True.
But the fact that it's there and it exists is fucking just. Like, the way his brows were furrowed because he was concerned about their well being, like. I don't know. Just these games have come so far. So, wow, 5.2 gigs. My computer's going to freak out.
That's still really good for like an hour
that's
and a
half.
That's true.
That is true.
Pew!
Yeah. Bye!
Just like, whoosh.
Yeah.
Even more sexy landscapes.
Right?
God damn. It's like they went straight to the desert and just like ripped these.
Pretty much. You mean like Grand Canyon
kind
of looking?
Yeah,
the limestone. I agree. Oh, and check this out, bro. Look at that water.
It is pretty good.
The swords of San Helios.
It's hella good.
With Arbiter's victories and the death of
I mean, some
Duel
of the things
Nama,
kind of, you kind of get distracted from, like, if you were to look, like, here and then look up. It's like, okay. That looks a bit not...
Well, that skybox looks pretty good.
Yeah, okay.
Well, I do want to praise one game for their water, and actually that's because there's water vehicles and water situations. It's fucking Battlefield 4. The waves actually look like real fucking waves. Like, it's incredible.
Nice.
Well, cool. Yeah, I guess that's it for now.
We're saving here. We'll be on Mission 8 next time, guys, and we hope you have enjoyed Halo.
A little
Jesse?
Bit more Halo, yeah, absolutely. Dude, I am super...
Look, yeah.
I love seeing Halo in this way because I actually get to see it played with its positives and its struggles. Not the game itself, but like you know,
yeah, like how difficult it is.
Yeah, and then also just be able to see the story and not have to play it myself because I suck at sticks.
All right, so next time on Rich. Stop it!
Okay,
God
sorry.
Damn it, Jesse. So next time on Retro Game Show, we will be back with more Halo and more games.
Yep.
Come on. We'll